Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and kind of following up a series on pro tennis players during the decade 2000 to 2011 and 12, and my experiences on the pro tour. Today I'm going to talk about a player named Bethanie Mattek. Now her married name is Sands, and she's an American player. She's done well in doubles. I've known her for a long, long time. 15 years old was when I first met her. That's an interesting story. I think it's one worth telling and sharing. That's why I'm doing it, especially to those who are believers in Christ, because it has an interesting application behind it. She was written about in Christian magazines when she was 15, and her story was put in a Focus on the Family magazine, which my board member, Mike Yorkie, was actually the editor of that magazine. I met him during that period of time, and he shared with me that they had just written a story about a junior player who is going to be a great player, and she was a Christian. So I read the story. And what came out in that story was that she was going to be number one in the world. They would interview, and that God was going to make her number one in the world. They interviewed people around her, her father, her trainer, her physical trainer, and he said, "I've never seen anybody as gifted as she is physically. God has given her this great physical strength, and she's going to be number one." And her father was saying that this was going to happen too. And at the time I read that, I thought, you know, first of all, we don't know who's going to be number one in the world. That's pretty unfair to a child to tell them that. And what happens if it doesn't happen? And so I knew the pressure probably was pretty incredible from a Christian perspective in her family. She came. I was able to get her contact, her coach's contact, and she came to play a tournament in Hong Kong, which is where I lived. And she was playing a junior ITF tournament, and I met up with her and her coach, who was Swanepoel from South Africa, and I gave him a tour of Hong Kong. We walked around, and you know, I showed him around, and she was just a junior player, and you know, I got to know him during that 2 or 3 day period, because I was spending all my time there with him. And interesting, at that same tournament was Andy Roddick, and she introduced me to Andy Roddick, who had just lost in the semifinals or the finals of that particular tournament, and I got a chance to talk to him. And he was just a known junior player. But Bethanie, you know, nice person. And I talked to her about faith, and she said all the right things. Knew what to say for sure, because her family had come from a church background. I think they maybe even served as pastors or in the church leadership somehow. And so she knew all the right things to say. That was it. We passed, and she went on her way, I went on my way. And then later on, I saw her at tournaments. I saw her, she was a very good doubles player when she went on the pro tour. She wasn't really able to make the singles main draws, and she was playing doubles. So she was in places, the French Open, and that first tournament I saw her, she was she made it to the quarterfinals with Abigail Spears. She gave me her credential to get into the tournament. And, you know, I saw a player who was very talented, very good in doubles. And what stood out, though, was that she wasn't really too excited about her Christian faith. And it didn't surprise me, because, you know, she was being told she was going to be number one in the world, and she wasn't number one in the world. She was far away from number one in the world. And so, you know, I just felt, well, I need to encourage her. And she's told me many times, you know, "You've known me a long time." And that's absolutely true. And so here she was, you know, she was playing, and I'd see her playing with different players and doubles as partners, and she'd have good results. And she's made finals of Grand Slams. I'm not sure what her Grand Slam records are, her highest ranking, but she's a very well-known player. She's done excellent in doubles. So in singles, she started to break into the main draw. Now, I had some time with her at the Australian Open, where she and I went out and had a coffee. I told her, I said, "Let's go out and have a talk." And you know, I knew that she was really struggling with her faith. She wasn't very happy, and because of what I shared with you. She wasn't married at the time, and she was just on the pro tour traveling. And, you know, I just tried to encourage her, you know, as a friend and spiritually, and she appreciated that. And then she met up with her husband at some point, and then she, you know, there she is. She's got a life with her husband, which is normal. And, you know, I've spoken to him, and he said that they go to church, which, you know, I'm not sure how active they are or whether it's very much an important part of their life. But I do know that, you know, it doesn't really show outside of on the pro tour much. And I think that her situation is that, you know, what I learned from that was that she was told things as a junior. It can happen with Christians. It can happen with non-Christians. You know, non-Christians are told you're going to be the greatest in the world, and, you know, your father could tell you that. It can happen with Christians, except they put God into the formula. God is going to make you the greatest player in the world. And nobody really knows the answer to that. And that can be very, very destructive to players. So I just think that that would be something that I would not encourage, and just say that God can be in charge of your life, and you can grow yourself and see where that takes you, and let Him make the results for where you're going to end up. Thanks.